This is for my fellow hunters!
Hi guys, this is Tabia Sobi, and today it's yippee-ki-yay time, boys and girls, as I go through the new Wyvern riding mechanics for mounting in Monster Hunter Rise. By the way, is it just me, or does Master Utsushi look like a ninja version of Kimtaku from Japanese boy band SMAP? Look at those moves. Anyway, I've been playing with the Monster Hunter Rise demo for a bit, and there's so much stuff to unpack, I'm having a tough time deciding where to start. That being said, I've always loved the mounting mechanic since it was introduced in Monster Hunter 4, so I thought that I should go ahead and start with that. Yeah, so mounting has been a part of the series, from Monster Hunter 4 through Iceborne, and while it has seen some changes, like the ability to slam a monster into a wall, the mechanic to get it started has pretty much stayed the same. That changes with Monster Hunter Rise, which is using a new mounting mechanic called Wyvern Riding for larger monsters. So in the older games, starting a mount basically involved using aerial attacks to lower a monster's resistance to mounting. Once you do this enough times, you'll be able to mount the monster and go through a little mini-game where you alternate between attacking and holding onto the monster until you either topple it or run out of stamina. In Monster Hunter Rise, mounting can now be done several ways. You can still use aerial attacks when using, say, the Insect Glaive, for example, but you can now also use Wirebug attacks, Silk Bind moves, as well as a special spider to initiate the mount. Once mounted, you no longer do the old mounting mechanic, but an entirely different sequence where you literally ride the monster. Anyway, here's a quick summary of the process for folks who are in a hurry. Got all of that? Now let's go more in depth. So how do you mount a monster in Monster Hunter Rise? As with previous games, getting monster into a mountable state requires you to inflict enough special damage toward mounting. It's almost like building status, except you use certain moves as opposed to a status attack. In Monster Hunter Rise, special mounting damage is actually denoted by a blue color on your damage numbers, which you'll notice when you're doing Wirebug aerial attacks, for example, or attacking with your Insect Glaive from the air. Inflicting damage yourself, however, is not the only way, and you have several methods at your disposal. The easiest way to trigger a mount is to use a puppet spider. It's basically a special white and yellow bug that you can find in the field and pick up. Doing so puts it in your item pouch, allowing you to use it like any other item. Just highlight it in your pouch and press Y to set it down like a trap while facing a monster. The puppet spider will then shoot the monster with webbing and stun it, putting it in a mountable state. Another way to inflict special damage for mounting is by using your Wirebug. You can do a regular Wirebug vault to send your hunter into the air and hit a monster with your weapon. You can also use a Silk Bind attack, also known as a Wirebug art, to attack the monster to build up special damage for mounting. Do this enough and the monster will eventually get stunned and enter a mountable state. Then of course there's the old-fashioned way of doing aerial attacks, which specially applies to the Insect Glaive since it allows you to easily do aerial vaults. That's because attacks that you do from an aerial vault will contribute to mounting damage as well. One more method is to make monsters fight each other. Just tap into your inner Loki and manipulate monsters to face each other and voila! You have another way to get monsters into a mountable state. So what moves can you do after you've mounted a monster? Once the monster is all prepped up and ready, just approach it and either hit it with an attack or press A if your weapon is sheathed, and it's time for you to hang 10. Cowabunga. This will cause you to stand atop of the monster like those Herodrim Elephant Riders from Lord of the Rings. Honestly, as a fan of Monster Hunter stories, I've always wanted them to add monster riding in the mainline games, so I guess this is the closest we'll get to that for now. Anyway, after you're done enjoying the view from the top, you'll notice that the mechanic differs from older Monster Hunter games based on the options you have at your disposal. By the way, don't forget to pay attention to your Wyvern riding timer, which shows how much time you've got left up there. After all, what goes up eventually must come down. The timer can also be reduced when you get hit while mounted, so keep that in mind. Anyway, one thing you can do is literally ride the monster and guide it around. Just press and hold the R button and use the directional stick to have the monster move. The other thing you can do is attack with the monster. You can press X to do a light attack or A to do a more powerful but slower strong attack. This will help build up your special Wyvern riding gauge for the special mounted Punisher move. Pressing B, by the way, will allow you to dodge. This is useful when facing another large monster, as getting hit will cause your ride to end sooner by eating up your mount timer. Another move that you can do while mounted is monster launching. Just press Y when facing a wall or, better yet, another monster, and you will send your conscripted buddy hurtling forward, kind of like the Clutch Claw Slam. This inflicts some nice damage to the monster and can also make it topple. However, you can also milk the move and do it repeatedly by pressing B right after the monster hits the wall. This allows you to stay mounted on the monster so you can wall slam it again. And again. And again. Do this enough times and the monster will eventually fall to the ground. And then last but definitely not least in your list of possible moves while Wyvern riding is the Mounted Punisher move. Like I mentioned previously, you can build this up by attacking with the mounted monster. By the way, once your Wyvern riding gauge is filled up, it will start going down until it's depleted. So your goal is to use the Mounted Punisher finisher before it runs out, especially if you're facing another monster. Ideally, you'll want to hit this on a monster that's either down or not moving around so much in order to ensure a hit. You then press X plus A to inflict massive damage that's enough to send historically accurate giant enemy crabs squirming in pain on the ground. Or a Mizutsune. Or a Great Izuchi. The world is your oyster. Anyway, you can now approach the down monster and give it a love tap. Or two. Or three. Or four. You catch my drift. Drifting, by the way, is another thing you can do when riding your doggy. But that's for another tutorial. Anyway, there you go. Now you are a bona fide Monster Hunter riding master. Just remember that with great power comes great responsibility. And maybe some wicked hang time. As always, feel free to leave any thoughts or questions you may have in the comment section. Once again, this is Tabi Asobi, and thank you for watching. Defossena!